Weekends can be a great block of time to knock out a trip that's relatively close by. But in order to get back to work on Monday, you gotta maximize your time. Saturday and Sunday, that's gonna go by quick. So how do you maximize your time? Let's talk about it. Hey everyone, it's Troy from FloatFreely.com, and today we're talking about maximizing a weekend trip. And the first thing I want to talk about is ensuring your transportation is booked. Making sure you have everything squared away beforehand, a few days beforehand, is crucial in squeezing out as much time as possible out of that weekend. And to do that, and what I've done many, many times, is to leave right after work on Friday, which means I either have my bags packed and in my car, or I have my bags packed and at the door ready to be picked up as soon as I get home. If you're taking a flight, which is possible to fly somewhere, spend a couple days and fly back in time for work on Monday, I've done it. It works. So book your flights on a Friday night. If possible, try to get in there like 6 or 7 o'clock. And then if you fly somewhere 3 hours away, you can be in your hotel room by midnight. That means when you wake up on Saturday morning, you're free to do whatever. And then book your returning flight on Sunday at 3 or 4 o'clock in the afternoon. So you still have a good half day on Sunday to do whatever you want. And then you can get home in a reasonable time to where you can still get a decent night's sleep for Monday morning. For driving, not too much different. Just make sure your car is gassed and ready to go. So if you do leave straight out of work, you can just hit the road and drive and not have to worry about gas for a while. But you know, getting gas only takes a few minutes. So for driving, there's not really too much preparation you need to take into consideration. Next, I want to talk about early check-in. You can potentially check in early, but a lot of times you'll have to pay some sort of cost. If you're going the Airbnb route, there's a check-in time because they usually have a cleaning crew come in and clean up the apartment before you move in. But if you check in early, it doesn't give that cleaning crew time. So they may charge you a fee because of that, whether they have to reschedule the cleaning, whether they have to do the cleaning earlier in the morning. Either way, you'll most likely be charged a fee. If you don't want to be charged the fee, another option is to book the lodging for an additional night. For example, let's say you're driving. Let's say you leave Saturday morning at like 6 a.m. You get to your destination at 11 a.m., but check-in's not until 3 p.m. So instead of walking around and doing whatever for 4 hours, you could have booked the hotel or you could have booked the Airbnb for Friday night as well, not checked in because you're still at home, but then check in at 6 a.m. the next day, or 11 a.m. the next day in this case. Probably the easiest way to do that is to book an Airbnb that has self-check-in. That way you don't have to coordinate with the host or anything like that. You can just go in and check in whenever you want, as long as it's past the check-in time. Same with hotels, it's easy, you know, because there's always someone at the hotel to check someone in. So if you arrive the next day, then hey, so be it. But either way, allowing yourself to get checked in early adds a couple hours to when you don't have to really worry about carrying your luggage everywhere or worrying about driving anywhere or pretty much wasting time until your lodging opens up. Next is to have your activities booked. I've talked about this in a few videos, but booking your activities out ahead of time is like probably one of the best advices I can give to you guys. I can't tell you how many times I planned on doing something at a certain location. And then when I get there and then the line's like out the door because everyone's like trying to buy tickets at the door to get in. Prime example is the Anne Frank Museum in Amsterdam. That line early in the morning was like wrapped around the block. It was insane. Had I bought my tickets beforehand, I wouldn't have had to worry about all that mess. Same with the Vatican. That line wrapped around the entire country that is Vatican City. If I would have bought beforehand, I would have just been able to walk up and go in. So it's always, always, always worth it to buy your activities beforehand. It's gonna save you a ton of time standing in line, not to mention probably the money you're gonna save as well booking beforehand, because tickets at the door almost always cost more than they do online. All right, fourth is to pack light. Like I said, this is a weekend trip. You don't need to pack a lot. Couple outfits. I usually pack 2 outfits per day, plus an additional 2 underwears and an additional 2 pairs of socks, because socks and underwear are super small. You can pack extras, and you never know when you might need an extra pair of underwear. Like the case of when I pooped my pants in Dubai, but that's a story for a different time. But I'm glad I had an extra pair of underwear, so pack extras. And I say that because when it comes to road tripping, it doesn't really matter because you're driving yourself, and if you take a big suitcase, you can just fit it in the trunk, no big deal. But if you're going the flying route, and especially if you live in Europe, or flights where you can take a couple hour flight and get to like anywhere in the continent, then packing light, packing with only a carry-on, potentially only even a personal item if you go for a backpack, and having everything you need for that weekend trip just in that bag will save you a ton of time, because then you don't have to worry about checking a bag in, you don't have to worry about picking your bag up on the other side, and traveling light is just so much easier. So if you do have to pass a couple hours before you can check into your hotel or Airbnb, then you're not lugging around a suitcase anywhere, you just have your backpack on, which looks more natural and is easier to maneuver than a suitcase and a big old piece of luggage. So yeah, try to pack light if all possible. And then the fifth thing, this isn't really about maximizing so much, it is about watch out for it. 9 out of 10 times, I don't take Monday off after a weekend trip. Even if I get back super late, 12 o'clock, 1 o'clock in the morning, I will end up going to work on Monday morning just because I'm stingy with my vacation days and I don't want to waste any if I don't have to. I can suffer through one day of work and then catch up on sleep Monday night in order for me to not use that vacation day on Monday. Because if I'm going to use the vacation day, I'm going to be on vacation while I'm on my vacation, if that makes sense. sense. So if you go that route and you get home late Sunday night and you have work Monday morning, be prepared for a rough day, a long day, a tired day. But man, that sleep Monday night is like the greatest. It's amazing. You'll wake up feeling even better on Tuesday morning. And that's all the tips I got for you about maximizing a weekend trip. Most of my trips have been, well, a good majority of my trips have been weekend trips. I've managed to save a ton of vacation days because of it. I've managed to see a lot of places because of it. And I think it's a great option for you to go. So if you enjoyed the video, I'd appreciate it if you went down, subscribed, hit that bell icon so you get notifications whenever I upload, as well as leaving a like and sharing this video with friends if you guys are planning a weekend trip soon. And with that being said, thank you guys for watching, and I'll see you in the next one.